Unity and the gift of life, and using us as vessels in your fire. Be that exalted, Lord, in Jesus' name. Have your way, Lord, Jesus' name. As I told you last week, that you get your water ready. Before we pray on this water, let me just tell you about mystery about water. Water contains two elements, that's hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen is the lightest gas, odorless and colorless. Hydrogen belongs to this atomic one. And let me tell you about it. By knowledge, people use it as a weapon. Weapon of mass destruction. There is nowhere it cannot penetrate. Oxygen is what life depends on. Without oxygen, you cannot live. Now, see these two opposite elements working together to sustain life. In the book of Genesis, you discover another mystery. When the first earth was destroyed, the only two things that was not destroyed was water and darkness. The enemy knows this, that is the devil. That is why he always likes to inhabit water. And whenever they inhabit water, we call them marine power. But we have superior power to project into water to be of benefit. Therefore, let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. As it is written in the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 1, that in the beginning, the Lord God made the heaven and the earth, and the earth was now formed and void, and darkness was upon the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the surface of water. I pray right now, let the Spirit of God move upon all the water right now in the name of Jesus Christ. It is written that that Spirit has a voice that says, let there be light. Let the light of God illuminate all this water now in the name of Jesus Christ. We overcome the dragon by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. Let the blood of the Lamb, the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, mingle with all this water now in the name of Jesus Christ. We receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon us as a cloven tongue of fire. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost incubate this water now in the name of Jesus Christ. There is a special anointing that Jesus Christ made us to know. The Lord Jesus Christ says, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, for he has anointed me. Let the anointing from the Spirit of the Lord God anoint this water now in the name of Jesus Christ. This water now is now water of deliverance. Anointed water to bring solution. Anointed water to bring healing. When you apply this water from now to anything that is bewitched, the bewitchment will disappear. When you apply this water, this anointed water, to anything that has been destroyed, those who will come back to life in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Jesus' name we pray. Use this water and you are going to share testimony in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, wonderful God. Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Want to continue in our series, Mystery Behind Enemy. And what we want to talk about today as an antidote is what all of us must really desire, is what we must really work on, is what we must really develop in our life. By the time we develop these things, we discover that we overcome our enemy easily. We are going to live a longer, better life that will confirm our fulfillment in life. What is this antidote? The antidote is Trinity. The Trinity here is knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. Now, let me first of all start with the word of the Lord Jesus Christ to tell you that Jesus Christ has really prepared very well for his ministry by knowledge, by understanding, and by wisdom. In the book of John, chapter 2, from verse 24, the Bible says, Jesus Christ did not commit himself into their hand. Why? The Bible says, because he knows man. He did not need anybody to tell him about man. He knows what is inside a man. Remember, in all this our series, we said, human beings are the carrier of demons. Demons are our enemy. and the demons in any human being make human being to become enemy of themselves. And we are now saying that, how do we overcome the enemy? What are the antidotes to the activities of the enemy? Now, today, I want to tell you, knowledge is very, very important. Knowledge is when you acquire some facts or you acquire some truth about a subject matter. The subject matter we are talking about today is human being. What are the characteristics of human being? By the nature of human being, the Bible confirms that the heart of human being is desperately wicked. Who can know it? It's only God that can know it. That is to say, whenever you are dealing with human being, know that you are dealing with wickedness. If you have that one at the back of your mind, you can never be disappointed. What is human being? Human being can be a regenerated personality. What do we mean by that? Any human being that have an encounter with Christ is a new creature by knowledge. Whenever you see new creature, you know that this one, they are humble, they are good, they are loving. So by the time you are dealing with that kind of human being, by knowledge, you will know what you can really do by them. What is human being? Human beings are subjected to changes. That is to say, I always say this one, whenever I'm preaching or teaching at time, I will say, when somebody is a Christian, if that person is not very careful, he has three states like water. You know, water can operate in the state of solid, it can operate in the state of liquid, it can operate in the state of gas. So also, at times, if somebody says he has a encounter with Christ, at times, he can be a backslider. At times, he can be an unbeliever. How do I know this? In the book of Matthew chapter 16, the Bible says, the Lord Jesus Christ asked the disciples, what did the people take him to be? And a lot of them begin to answer. Some say you are a prophet, some say you are Elijah, some say you are this and that. And I say, okay, you, what do you think I am? What do you say I am? And Peter said, you are Christ, the Son of the Most High God. And Jesus Christ looked at Peter and said, it is not flesh and blood that reveal this one to you, but it is my Father. And immediately, Jesus Christ now begin to define what is Christ, what Christ come to do here on earth, how Christ will suffer, how Christ will die. The Bible now says, Peter brought Jesus Christ out and rebuked him. And Jesus Christ look at Peter, because Peter was no longer that Holy Spirit incarnate again. He has become a satanic incarnate. And Jesus called him by his name and said, Satan, get behind me. Now, Jesus Christ knows the nature of human beings, that they are subjected to changes. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 17, after 6 days, Jesus Christ took Peter, James, and John. You know, by knowledge, by understanding, and by wisdom, the Lord Jesus Christ knows the nature of human beings. So to really overcome the enemy, to really have victory over the enemy, you must have knowledge about human being. In the book of Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, the Bible says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. The Bible did not say other people. It's the Lord God said, my people, that is the regenerated people, the Christian, they are destroyed for lack of knowledge. You understand? In that book of Proverbs chapter 18, verse 24, the Bible says, whosoever that hath friend must behave friendly. All these things may look so psychological. You know, there are some people that it is because of their character. That is why they recruit many enemies to themselves. If those people can just change their mindset, they can just change their way and understand other people and become friendly to other people, they will just see that some minor enemy, some physical enemy, they can easily overcome them. Praise the name of the Lord. You know, in that book of 1 Samuel, chapter 18, or that, the Bible says that David behaved himself wisely. before Saul. And because he behaved himself wisely, the Bible now commands that Saul was afraid of him. You understand? Because David, by knowledge, knows that Saul is the king. And Saul is an anointed man of God. And Saul has power to lead deal with him. Though he was anointed, David was anointed to replace Saul, David did not allow that anointing to go too much into his life and now begin to have pride and begin to exhibit all those that he has for now. He'll be the one that will replace Saul. If not, Saul will just kill him anyhow. But the Bible says he behaved wisely. And because of that, Saul was afraid of him. So, which means David is overcoming the enemy on a gradual form. What are we saying? Get knowledge. Eh? In that book of Proverbs chapter 4 verse 7, the Bible says, wisdom is the principal thing. It costs all. But in all, get understanding. By the time you have these three things, you will live a good life. You see, there are some people, I do pity them most of the time, to God be the glory for aggressive prayer. I love aggressive prayer. I love ascetic prayer very, very well. But by the time you return back from that prayer, when you are dealing with people in the physical realm, for God's sake, don't frown your face too much. Don't discriminate. Don't look down on other people as if this one as sinner. Don't look at just everybody as your enemy. Get me right? By understanding, you can be violent in the spirit, and you can be gentle in the physical. When you are a carrier of the fire of God, as we said last week, it is the enemy that will be running away from you. But in the physical, the fruit of the spirit must really manifest. You must exhibit it. By the time you exhibit all those fruit of the spirit, before you know it, you will have more friends than the enemy. There are some enemy that are compulsory enemy that no matter how gentle you may be, they must be your enemy. But there are some enemy that we recruit by ourselves. Those enemy is only our character that we can really use to overcome them. If we pray millions prayer, they have little ground in our life. It may not work. God bless you. We'll continue from this next week. Use that water wisely, and you call me that God answer your prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, wonderful God. And as I always say, accept Christ into your life so that you can make him. Call on him today as you confess your sin. He will forgive you and save you from the bondage of sin. God bless you till we meet next week. In Jesus' name, amen.